In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of neck flexors and neck extensors. In first part, I'm going to explain neck flexors. I will explain deep part of neck flexors first. You see this thin, long muscle? This is longus capitis. Longus capitis. Long head muscle. Plus there is longus coli close to longus capitis. Okay, longus capitis and longus coli. These muscles are in front of cervical spines. No wonder they can do neck flexion. Imagine these muscles contract kind of this way, then what's gonna happen? Neck flexion. Easy, right? Plus, tiny muscles can do neck flexion. Let's see these guys. This one is rectus capitis lateralis. Rectus capitis lateralis. Then this one is rectus capitis anterior. They are very tiny muscles, so they can't exert a lot of power for flexion. But anyway, these are also neck flexors. These muscles are very deep. Then I'm going to explain kind of a superficial neck flexors. Okay, there are flexor muscles on superficial part. I'm gonna explain one unique muscle. This is sternocleid mastoid, let's say SCM, sternocleid mastoid. This muscle also can do flexion. However, sternocleid mastoid act as flexor when neck is on flexion position. Okay, in neutral position, this muscle doesn't do flexion, but when you go flexion, then you want to go more flexion, sternocleid mastoid act as neck flexor. Interesting, right? Anyway, sternocleid mastoid, SCM. Then there are muscles beneath hyoid bone. This is hyoid. There are muscles attaching to hyoid, then below hyoid. This muscle group is called infrahyoid muscles. Infrahyoid muscles. They are in front of neck, so they can do neck flexion indirectly. They don't attach to cervical spines, but when they contract, they can bring neck and head to flexion. Okay, remember, they don't attach to neck and head. If there is infrahyoid, there should be suprahyoid. Yes, correct. There are suprahyoid muscles above hyoid bone. They also can do neck flexion. So, suprahyoid muscles. Again, they don't attach to neck and head. Well, one muscle attached to head, but other muscles don't attach to neck and head. Anyway, suprahyoid and infrahyoid can do neck flexion. That's about it. So first part was longus coli and longus capitis, rectus capitis lateralis, rectus capitis anterior, sternocleid mastoid, infrahyoid muscles, and suprahyoid muscles. Let's go to neck extensors. Okay, let me explain neck extensors. By the way, there are few shoulder girdle muscles that can do neck extension, such as trapezius and levator scapula. However, I will not explain about shoulder girdle muscles today. I'm gonna explain neck muscles. Okay, first one is This one, again, sternocleidomastoid mastoid. This muscle acts as neck extensor when neck is on extended position. Do you remember when it works for flexion? This muscle acts as neck flexor when neck is on flexion position. Vice versa, when neck is on extended position, sternocleidomastoid acts as neck extensor. So this muscle is quite unique. Then there are many neck muscles, right? Such as splenius capitis. Splenius capitis, splenius cervicis. And erector spinae. Erector. They are back muscles, neck muscles, right? There are many back muscles, big neck muscles and tiny neck muscles. There are numerous neck muscles on backside. So these are kind of example. Basically, neck extensors are on back part of neck, of course. And neck flexors are in front of cervical spines. Except sternocleidomastoid is on lateral part of neck. It's simple, right? These muscles can do neck extension because they are on posterior part. These guys can do flexion because they are on anterior part. Simple enough, right? Now at last, let me explain deep part of backside of neck. Okay, this is deep muscle. There are four deep muscles on upper cervical spines. These guys are suboccipital muscles. Suboccipital muscles or suboccipitals. These four muscles are very tiny, however, they can do neck extension. These guys are not big as splenius capitis and splenius cervicis, but function of these guys are important for upper cervical spines. Why is upper cervical spines important? Because there are many proprioceptors. Because there are many proprioceptors around suboccipitals. Proprioceptions or proprioceptor. What is this? What is proprioception? That is a sensation that you know where your body is. You know what kind of posture you are taking right now, right? So proprioception is like a balance sensor of body and joint. Anyway, suboccipitals can do neck extension, plus this is key part for body balance. In this video, I explained neck flexors and neck extensors. Basically, anterior neck muscles can do flexion. Posterior neck muscles can do extension. Except sternocleidomastoid can do both. If neck is on flexed position, it can do flexion. If neck is on extended position, it can do neck extension. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.